The main distinction of the Cleveland campus is our urban location. And students who are excited about practicing in urban areas that have their own unique challenges gravitate towards our campus for their training.
I enjoyed the fact that it was brand new. It was something exciting.
My family's in Cleveland, so I've grown up here, and so that was a really big pull.
We have all of the same resources as we do in Athens, but we have a small family feel, so everyone knows everyone.
I really liked the opportunity to have such a big healthcare system, like the Cleveland Clinic.
The students really benefit from our partnership with the Cleveland Clinic in multiple ways. One of the key ways, of course, is that when they're ready for their clinical education, they're going to get to do a lot of their training throughout Cleveland Clinic's enterprise.
Our pod rooms where we have our lectures are like no other learning environment that I've had before. It's kind of cool. You kind of have two screens where you see everything going on, and then you kind of have like a buzzer in the middle where you can either ask questions or answer questions and things like that, and it just helps us stay connected. Our school is really unique because we do have three campuses, Cleveland, Dublin, and Athens, but we're all very united, and I like that about our school.
OMM stands for Osteopathic Manipulative Medicine, and it's a technique that we have as osteopathic physicians where we use our hands to diagnose and treat. And basically, it just promotes the body's natural ability to heal itself. The professor will give a demonstration of the techniques that we'll be learning that day, and then from there, we break out into our own groups. When we're out in the field, it's just an added tool that we have that we can use besides prescribing something. I think that our anatomy curriculum has to be one of the best.
In lecture, you'll learn a lot of the nitty-gritty details of the molecules that govern all the reactions in your body, but in the lab you actually see how everything's mechanically put together. We can have different professors presenting from different campuses, and we can all work together as a class, all 250 some of us, not just the Cleveland campus on its own. At all times, the highest amount of respect is given to the donors and their families. We even have a ceremony, and we pay our respects to their great sacrifice and to their lives.
CTAC is the Clinical Training and Assessment Center. They're essentially standardized hospital rooms or physical rooms. In those spaces, we interact with simulated patients and hone our skills, really.
You also just get used to interacting with patients. At first, I was very nervous talking to patients and just walking in a room and saying, hey, how's it going, and you know, doing a checkup. But at this point in the year, I feel much more comfortable and confident in my clinical skills.
Patients want someone with whom they have a real relationship and who they can trust. So creating practitioners who have that very real connection with their patients is the key.
On top of all of that, we have an OR room, and I think that that's just a really unique opportunity.
The mannequins are great in being able to simulate an acute situation that we wouldn't see otherwise as first and second year students.
Having more comfortable and informal spaces to study is definitely a plus.
Our group study rooms are where we do some of our collaborative learning. They're open, so when people are walking by and if they see you doing something that they're working on, they're like, oh, maybe this person can help me out, and people will stop by and ask questions.
The Learning Resource Center is essentially a library. There's two sections of it. One is a quiet space that also contains all of the books that we would need, and it's just a great place for us to have those resources but not necessarily purchase every book. The staff and faculty are very accessible. Everyone is available.
You don't ever have to feel like you can't get a hold of a professor or a student. Everybody's virtually linked, so to speak.
Dr. Kirstein does couch time, and what that is just an opportunity for students to sit and meet with him informally, and so it just gives this campus specifically a very personal touch.
It's very nice to have an administration here that really puts effort into making relaxing events for us as well. We have the ping pong room, we have the game console room, also kind of the hangout room.
We have a workout room with machines, there's free weights, we have bands, mats for, you know, people want to do yoga. We have cardio machines, you know, you can run and study at the same time.
And when we do get time to go outside and get some fresh air, we do have a nice gazebo and some place to sit outside, catch some sun.
You can obviously have a life in Cleveland and be a medical student, it's no big deal.
I really liked the idea that you are looking at the whole patient, not just their medical illnesses, but their psychosocial background.
To me, Cleveland's home. It's where I was born and raised. So to me, it was a no-brainer to come to Cleveland because this is my community.
My mission is to heal, and especially in the community where I'm going to be practicing and where I'm learning right now.
I think that we together can build something so amazing for the patients of Cleveland. So we're really looking for people from this area who want to come home and make a difference.